One of the most insidious ways a domestic abuser can control and threaten a victim is by the threat of violence against their pets. Now, the government has passed new laws to try and stop that from happening, looking after the animals while their owners try to escape.
When Tali Starr was growing up in a violent household, her beloved pet birds were used to control her and keep her quiet.
And it was about trying to continue the abuse, because they had this power and control by taking my animals and wanting to harm them.
As an adult, it was her love for her cats that trapped her in an abusive marriage.
I delayed leaving because I had nowhere to take my animals. I didn't want to be separated from them. They were my only family.
Ms Starr now works for Frontline Services, trying to change the system. And new laws passed in New South Wales are a welcome step forward.
And what we're doing now is recognising animal abuse explicitly as a form of intimidation, and having a standard condition in apprehended domestic violence orders prohibiting harm to animals or the threat of harm to animals.
That means any ADVO issued will now also protect the victim's pets. A recent survey of frontline workers found animal abuse was reported by up to 60% of victims, but only 4% said their local domestic violence service adequately catered for pets in danger. That's also about to change, as the state government commits $500,000 to upgrading both animal shelters and women's refuges so they can take in the pets of victims fleeing violence.
And also to train the staff at the RSPCA and places like that about domestic abuse so they can recognise the signs when an animal is brought in.
Their pets will be brought here and kept in a secure section away from the public, where they'll be cared for by RSPCA staff until their humans are safe and ready to take them home again.
The PAWS program will be up and running soon, and the government says it's only the beginning.
And as the minister responsible, I'm keen to see more, and that's what I'll be pursuing.
Working towards a safe haven for every woman and her dog. Leah Harris for 10 News First.
And if you or someone you know is a victim of domestic violence, there is support. You can call the 24-hour hotline 1-800-RESPECT. That's 1-800-737-732.